Mimi, everyone, welcome back to Witchy Words with Zabora. I'm your host, Zabora, and today's witchy word is polytheist. Now, polytheism comes in many forms. It comes in hard, soft, and even dual form monotheism, or plural form monotheism, excuse me. So there is hard polytheist, which is the belief that the gods are distinct entities from one another. Kali is not Sekhmet. Then there's soft polytheism, which is the belief that all gods are one god and all goddesses are one goddess. Sekhmet and Kali are both war goddesses, so they must be linked. Then you have plural form monotheism, which is the belief that all gods are one god, all goddesses are one goddess, and together they are one divine unit that manifests as a feminine and a masculine entity, because this vast entity is completely unknowable to us in its primordial form. Now, this sort of links up with the Yoruba religion, which is where hoodoo comes from, which is kind of what I practice. The Orishas acted as go-betweens between the god and the people. They were sometimes human spirits that have moved on, sometimes inhuman spirits that were more like angels and stuff. They're non-human entities that were created by this distinct god. And I'll never be able to say the name. So just Google it if you're interested. But they basically act like an intermediate to act on your behalf. Now, you do find this in like Catholicism and stuff. When you pray to a saint, that saint then petitions God or works on your behalf in order to get you the desire you're looking for, whatever you're praying to the saint for. So if I were to like pray to Saint Michael and light a Saint Michael candle to destroy all my enemies, okay, Saint Michael would then work on my behalf to go to God and be like, hey, one of your children needs help. Now, I personally don't play that way. I don't use intermediates when it comes to my magic. I go straight for it. So, but you know, this is a belief that some people have. So you're really just going to have to kind of come up with your own ideas about how you feel about God. Now, I know that there are a few of you who watch my videos that are still kind of seeking what it is that you believe, and that's totally fine. That's completely fine. And in 10 years, when you think you have it all figured out and you learn something new and you completely just flip your shit, that's totally fine too. But you should still be open and able to explore and everything else. So that is polytheism. It's basically just the belief in more than one deity. And they are usually distinct and separate from each other, except in the form of plural form monotheism. But then that becomes monotheism and not really polytheism. Now, great examples in ancient Egypt would be Bast and Sekhmet. Bast being from I think northern Egypt and Sekhmet being from southern Egypt, or maybe they're flipped, but they were both lion-headed entities that were goddesses of war, but they were distinct and separate from each other. One was worshipped in the north and one was worshipped in the south. Until I think about 6,000 years ago, when the Scorpion King, yes, there really was a Scorpion King, and King Djoser, I think that's how you say it, maybe it's Djoser. Around that time, when the Great Pyramids, before the Great Pyramids were even built, the land became united under a single king. And it is possible, Egyptologists do believe that it actually was three distinct kings that were kind of combined into Djoser, including one of them was the Scorpion King that was combined. Anyway, so Sekhmet and Bast, different entities until they were combined. So then now you have Sekhmet, Bast, Tefnut, and Hethert, who are all linked to each other, that are all distinct deities, but all seem to be also the same deity because they're all eyes of Ra. Ra's another one. Ra was also Khepri, who pushed the sun in the form of a dung beetle across the sky every morning. He was also Atum, who was the old man who needed the walking cane late at night at sunset because, you know, he was dying. He became Osir in the underworld when he fused with him to bring life to Osir and allow the cycle to continue. He was Sekhmet's father. He was Sekhmet's son in the form of Nefertim. So it's really quite surprising to see how much like soft polytheism that was going on in ancient Egypt. But the religion was never stagnant. It was always changing to fit the people and the times. So that's why I feel really comfortable with updating Egyptian rituals, because they themselves were never stagnant. It was a very moving, flowing religion. So yeah, I hope that this has been enlightening. I think our next word that we're going to cover is going to be henotheism. Maybe I'll do some monolatry. And we'll talk even about pantheism. So that's it for tonight, guys. Synapti.